Real Research LifeGel, presented by its CEO, Marcin Krzykawski.
Hello. I'd like to tell you a story of how our company actually started. Some time ago, a few years ago, I've been talking to my friend about my PhD project, and I told him that I can create a tumor that is 1 centimeter in diameter. And for those of you that are not in the field, 1 centimeter tumor to grow in the lab, it's really a hard task. My friend didn't believe me, and I trusted in my skills, so we decided to bet for a bottle of wine. Making long story short, after half year of hard work, I had to admit that I failed, and I had to give this bottle to my friend. But this is not the end of the story. This is actually the beginning of the story, because the most important thing is that I learned actually why I failed, and I learned that most of the biotech companies and pharma companies face the same problem I faced, and I want to share this problem with you today. So, have you ever thought about how new drugs are being created? Well, for those of you that don't know, if a company decides to create a new drug, they actually create about 10,000 potential drugs that go through laboratory testing and like computer simulations, and after a lot of work, they narrow it down to about 1, maybe 5 potential drugs that can enter clinical trials. And this would be okay if not for 3 major problems. First one is that it takes too many years. It can take up to 15 years to go through this process. Second, it costs much more than $1 billion. And third, and most important thing, is that at the end of the whole process, you end up with less than 5% chance of really finding the right drug. And this is something unacceptable, and this is the wall that has to fall, because we cannot wait so long, and we cannot waste so much money to get the chance of having a new drug. And we decided to devote our careers to tackle this problem and find the solution. So, what is actually the problem and why it's so important? Imagine a person living in a society with his friends and family, being surrounded by everybody and communicating with everybody, and then take this person and place them into a desert with nobody around them and nobody to talk to. It sounds a bit broken, isn't it? Well, the problem is that we do exactly the same mistake in life science. We take a cell from a patient that this cell grows in its natural environment, it's a 3-dimensional environment of the human body, and we place it on a flat plastic dish where those cells can barely touch one another or communicate with one another. And later on, we actually make very serious decisions based on what those cells will tell us. And we decide whether the drug should work or shouldn't based on this very weird environment. So how it looks in real life. This is the 2-dimensional cell culture. It's a flat cell culture that you can find in every lab. Here's what you would actually expect in human body, like a 3-dimensional structure. And imagine like nobody in our bodies has any plastic to grow the cells on. And this is actually what we have created. What we are doing is we are using exactly the same type of tumors to create 3-dimensional cell cultures in the laboratories. And there are many benefits of this process, but there is one I want to share with you the most, because I've been working with animals, is when you're using cell cultures, you can actually decrease the number of animals necessary for your research. So let me introduce you to our first product, LifeGel. LifeGel is a hydrogel for 3D cell cultures. So we have identified 3 major problems on the market that our competitors have. And the problems are that their product is contaminated, it's not repeatable, and it's very hard to scale. So what we have done, we have created a product that is very pure, it's highly repeatable, and it's easy to scale. It is actually so easy to scale that since we are a very small company at this moment, we can, in a half year, we can increase the production to supply half of the global demand. But what is the global demand? At this moment, the global demand is about half a billion euro in 2013, but it's going to grow to 2.2 billion in 2019. I'm trying to show you that the revolution is coming, because this market is growing 30% every year, and it has been broken for the last 70 years because everybody has been doing the research on two-dimensional cell cultures, and we want to make the revolution rather the evolution. So with the real research and LifeGel, we want to change how science is being done. And one more thing. Today, I think we would be much closer to winning this bet with my friend. Thank you.